Hello, I'm Sonal Pradeshi, a product marketing manager from the Office Ecosystem team. I'm going to talk to you today about how your customers can manage and deploy your add-ins within their organization using the Office 365 Centralized Deployment feature. Here's a problem that a number of ISVs have struggled with over the years. You've done a great job selling your solution into an organization, but the last hurdle can be the hardest. How do you deploy the add-in within that customer's organization so that it's targeted to the specific people that will use the add-in? There have been multiple options available to support this so far, including downloading directly from the store or using the add-in catalog, but none of them have really solved that problem directly. They didn't support a deployment model where the add-in appeared within the Office application that they use day in and day out. Now, with centralized deployment, your customers have the ability to target the users that they want to deploy the add-in to. How do you use centralized deployment to deploy add-ins? There are two primary options. You can either upload an add-in from the Office store, or an add-in manifest XML file can be uploaded. If your add-in is in the Office store, this is a great option, as it makes it very easy for the administrator to locate your add-in and then upload it. It also has the benefit of auto-updating the add-in, so the administrator doesn't need to keep track of it. This is a great option for add-ins where the manifest will be the same across all customers. However, if the add-in manifest can vary across customers, like line of business or any custom add-ins, then the manifest XML upload is a better option. This does mean, though, that manifests updated need to be managed by the administrator. In either case, the add-in can be uploaded via Office 365 Admin Center or via PowerShell and assigned to the users and or groups that the add-in is targeted to. This feature was built to be designed for corporate deployments. It also requires no additional client or server configuration. And if the add-in supports add-in commands, it will automatically show up within the Office application for that user. I'm in the Office 365 Admin Center now, and on the Services and Add-ins page. On this screen, you will see the add-ins that are currently available and uploaded to the tenant so far. Now I'm going to upload a new add-in. This could be done via the store, but in this case, I'm going to upload a manifest file. First, I'm going to browse for my citations add-in. We did some simple validation here to ensure that it conforms to the correct format schema of add-ins, and now it's ready to assign to users and or groups. In this case, we're going to assign it to the sales team and to Ben Walters. So Ben and other members of the sales team group will now have access to the citations add-in. We have saved the file for the organization, and you can see here in Admin Center that citations is now available for the tenant. Let us switch now to the client application, which in this case is Word, to see that the add-in was deployed. Let me start up Word, signed in as Ben Walters. And if I go to the add-in in the ribbon under the Admin Manage tab, here you will see that Ben has access. So let me add the citations add-in. It says that the add-in was loaded successfully. And now if I navigate to the References tab, here you will see that the citations add-in is available for use. Thank you very much for watching this video today. I hope you and your customers will be excited to use the centralized deployment feature to target the relevant users of your add-ins. If you would like more information on centralized deployment, please refer to the documentation and resources on dev.office.com.